Hello friends, when getting a house built, we want every single detail to be picture perfect. Along with the perfect outlook, we also desire a house that is both comfortable and durable. From the rooftop to the smallest tile on the driveway, every aspect of building a new house requires meticulous planning. Floors are one of the first things that make an impact on you as you enter a room. If you don't like anything in your room, from decor to the wall color to the furniture, it's quite easy to get it changed. But the same doesn't apply to flooring. Changing your floor treatment is a challenging and time-taking process. Hence, choosing your flooring needs significant consideration and care. You might get confused about whether to go for a tiled floor or a marble floor. So in this video, we will discuss the differences between these two. So let us start. Composition. Marble is a natural stone which is made by limestone's metamorphic crystallization that results in conversion of calcium carbonate into calcium crystals. On the other hand, tile is a man-made product which is a mixture of clay and other minerals such as quartz, silica and feldspar, baked at high temperatures which forms a glassy substrate throughout, giving it a smooth texture. Appearance. Marble is a natural stone product mined from quarries, so each tile is unique in appearance. All tiles for your project should come from same cut of stone in order to get the best match. Some white or light colored marble can look translucent, making them a very attractive floor covering. Marble flooring has long been the symbol of luxury and opulence. While vitrified tiles are available in a huge array of eye-catching colors and finishes, the overall look is less authentic when compared to natural wood or stone. While it is possible to create a fox marble or wood effect using vitrified tiles, the grout lines in laying of floor tiles are more visible when compared to marble. Porosity and stain resistance. Marble is porous in nature, so it absorbs water and other substances, which leads to stains. It gets affected by acids or alkali. It is for this reason marble has to be polished. But if marble is cleaned immediately, the stains and spills do not get absorbed. To remove stains from marble, it has to be cleaned regularly with lukewarm water and a mild detergent. Also, the porosity of marble varies from quality to quality, and some manufacturers offer the low porosity imported marble variants that are stain resistant to a large degree. Application of sealant from time to time fixes the problem of moisture and porosity and also brings back the lustrous finish anew. Whereas tiles are non-porous, they do not absorb water or other liquids. This helps in making them stain resistant, and that's why they are easy to maintain. They are not affected by acids or alkali and are thus perfect to be used in high moisture areas like bathrooms and kitchen. Tiles can be easily cleaned with water and a soft cloth. Varieties or finishes. Marble flooring is available in blocks, slabs, or tiles. Commonly found in shades of white, black, green, brown, grey, yellow, and other natural hues. Different grades of marble will absorb water differently. Marble comes with polished finish, honed or smooth finish, tumbled or antique finish, sand or abrasive or brush finish, flamed finish, bush hammered finish, sandblasted finish, etc. On the other hand, tiles are available in both glazed and unglazed varieties. Tiles come in a large variety of colors, prints, finishes, textures and designs that gives an artistic impact. Even tiles are designed to mimic natural materials such as wood, bamboo, and even marble. Vitrified tiles or porcelain tiles can be found in matte, anti-skid, granular, or glossy variants. Variations. Marble is a natural stone, and as such, wide differences can be spotted in the same stone of the same lot. For this reason, marble is less consistent than tiles. On the other hand, during manufacturing of tiles, the appearance and color of tiles are carefully controlled, and this results in an end product that comes with slightly minor variations between batches. Eco-friendly. Marble cannot be considered as an eco-friendly option as it is a non-renewable resource and extracting it requires energy-intensive processes. The impact of these processes on the environment is irreversible. On the other hand, tiles are better than marble as it can be recycled, non-toxic, and are manufactured using safe processes. As tiles are composed of natural clay and other plentiful raw materials, their production does not require the exploitation of any other natural resources such as trees or rock. Wastage. During cutting of marble to a suitable sizes, the wastage component increases. Whereas tiles are manufactured in factories, hence wastage component is low. Installation. The installation process of marble is time-consuming and cumbersome. Marble floors should be installed by an expert. Marble tiles can be fragile and difficult to match and therefore should be laid out on your floor before installation to make sure you are happy with the overall design. It is very difficult to transport marble from one place to another. In most places in India, marble is usually not available in a ready-to-ship condition. You have to place an order followed by cutting and grinding of marble to your requirements. Marble requires many processes such as cutting, grinding, polishing, and finishing. Marble flooring takes around 7 days for complete installation. Whereas vitrified tiles are usually easier to install as compared to marble. Tiles can be cut manually and they already come with a good polishing, hence on-site finishing is not required. Vitrified tiles are available in stores in a ready-to-ship condition and usually it takes around 1.5 to 2 days to lay flooring in a standard size room. These tiles also require less setting time and you can use them shortly after installation. After installation, if any tile breaks, then it's impossible to get the same tile. So while installing tiles, you should always have extra stock of tiles which has to be kept for the future. Durability and life. Not only marble is an attractive option for use around your home, it has a good and remarkable strength. It is a good choice if you want flooring with a long lifespan, even though it might turn yellowish with age. With proper cleaning, maintenance, sealing, and adequate care, marble flooring can remain intact for around 25 years. Whereas tiles are both discoloration and scratch resistant and thus will easily hold good for a span of 10 to 15 years when used with proper maintenance. However, vitrified tiles have a low strength and they are prone to breakage. Heat transfer. Marble stone is cool underfoot, so if you are living in a hot area where temperature is usually high, then marble is a good choice for you. Areas where temperature is usually low for a longer duration, you can mix this flooring type with other flooring types to give warmth to a design. On the other hand, tiles doesn't have this kind of property. Resale value. Marble tile floors can increase the resale value of a home, but only if they have been installed and maintained properly. Porcelain or vitrified tile floors don't have a big impact on resale value because they are lower cost and much more common. Maintenance. Due to the porous nature of marble, it absorbs water and reacts very easily with most substances, leading to stains. Marble reacts with even dilute acids found in the kitchen such as lemon juice, vinegar, mustard, citrus, and other common household items, causing stains. To prevent staining, you must clean any spills on the marble flooring immediately to prevent permanent marks. You can clean the floor with mild detergent and water. Marble flooring will also require periodic application of a sealant to protect it from moisture and to maintain its shine and luster. After the initial installation and sealing, it's recommended that you reseal your marble tile every 6 to 12 months depending on how much foot traffic it gets. Marble tile is also susceptible to chips, cracks, and breakage and can be scratched by vacuuming. On the other hand, vitrified tiles are relatively easy to clean and maintain. Being non-porous, vitrified tiles do not absorb water or any other liquid, which makes them stain resistant. Also, they are resistant to abrasive substances and are not affected by acids or alkalis. Regular dusting and wiping is enough to keep your tiles gleaming. Use. Each piece of marble highlights uniqueness and is believed to be a symbol of luxury. Marble flooring is a very high class and commonly used in posh homes, restaurants, hotels, temples, churches, mosques, etc. Marble is the best choice for indoor areas like halls and bedrooms. Marble tiles are not recommended for humid or wet areas like kitchens, bathrooms, outdoor spaces like exterior walls, landscaping, pathway, corridors, or basements, because marble will absorb moisture, which can lead to staining, warping, dulling, and deterioration over time. Due to its polished finish, marble can be very slippery when wet. Marble is not suitable for cold climate. Marble is not suitable for high traffic areas as it may lose its shine. On the other hand, vitrified tiles can be used for both indoor and outdoor applications, as well as high traffic areas. Since they are available in various anti-slip or slip-resistant finishes, vitrified tiles are good for bathrooms and kitchens as well. Tile is suitable for all climates. Price. Being natural stone, marble has to be mined and extracted using costly procedures. Moreover, only high-quality marble looks good in appearance, which comes at an exorbitant price. The price of marble flooring will also vary according to the grade, rarity of color, etc. Typically, the cost of Indian marble flooring, including the cost of material, labor, as well as cutting and polishing charges, is around 250 rupees per square feet, while other varieties such as Italian marble can cost anywhere between 650 to 1000 rupees per square feet. Marble needs to be cut into specific sizes before installation. After that, laying, polishing, grinding, and finishing of marble turns to be a costly process. Whereas, the cost of vitrified tile flooring largely depends on the design and brand you choose. The cost of installation shall be around 25 rupees per square feet, and the cost of bedding material like cement and sand shall be around 15 rupees per square feet. The cost of tile varies from 20 rupees per square feet to 150 rupees per square feet, depending on brand. So accordingly, the rate per square feet for tile flooring varies from 60 rupees per square feet to 190 rupees per square feet. Being man-made, these tiles are more affordable when compared to marble. Tiles come in variety of styles and in different ranges with cost-effective installation. They are available in all price range to suit every budget. The people who are looking forward to a cost-effective solution should opt for tile as a flooring option. Depending on your use, budget, maintenance, and design needs, you can make a correct choice. Before you make your final decision, take a look and see if you can even noticeably tell the difference between marble and tile. Manufacturers are becoming such pros at mimicking natural stone, you can hardly tell the difference. The only choice you have left to make is your preference on maintenance and price. So friends, see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.